An appeal, the Chiefs will be without a key piece of their linebacking core starting this week. The NFL confirms it has suspended linebacker Willie Gay Jr. for violating the league's personal conduct policy. Gay is out starting this Sunday against the Colts for 4 games without pay. The suspension stems from Gay's January arrest in Overland Park on a misdemeanor criminal damage charge. At the time, Gay's representative told Fox 4 News Gay was visiting his son and broke a vacuum in an argument with the child's mother. Police were called. Gay was arrested. He eventually pleaded guilty and entered a diversion program. It's not clear if he will appeal, but for now he's eligible to return in Week 7 versus the 49ers. Gay has 16 tackles in 2 games so far this season.
Breaking news from yesterday, Willie Gay suspension and AFC West in shambles for every team besides your Kansas City Chiefs, who we're going to talk about in today's video.
65 toss by our trap. That might pop wide open, Rats.
News came out yesterday that linebacker Willie Gay will be suspended for 4 games for breaking league personal conduct. Willie Gay suspended for 4 games. Last year, he got in a conflict with his ex-girlfriend. Broke some things, broke some property at her house. A door, an iPhone, and a vacuum. Totaled up to $1,000. Kind of crazy that the NFL is suspending Willie Gay for 4 games. I do think Willie Gay should get some type of discipline from the NFL. I don't know if it should be a 4-game suspension. 4-game suspension is pretty harsh, where we've seen players get 2-game suspensions or just hefty fines. We saw Mike Evans the other day assault somebody on a football field, and he only got 1-game suspension. I do think Willie Gay should get a game suspension or maybe 2-game suspension and a hefty fine. 2-game suspension, a hefty fine is what I usually see from stuff like this. He did not hurt anybody. There was no physical harm done to anybody. But Willie Gay will mix the next 4 games, and those games will be the Indianapolis Colts, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, the Oakland Raiders, and the Buffalo Bills. So those 4 games Willie Gay will miss. And the big game I think will be crucial for Willie Gay being missed will be that Buffalo Bills game against Josh Allen. And we saw Josh Allen last night on Monday Night Football running around making huge plays for the Buffalo Bills. They are the real deal this season. They were my Super Bowl pick before the season, and sadly, I still have to ride with them as my Super Bowl pick, even though I'd love to see my Kansas City Chiefs get into the Super Bowl. But Josh Allen and the Bills are absolutely rolling right now. Now the question is, who's going to step up in Willie Gay's absence? And that guy's got to be Leo Chanel. Can Leo Chanel step up? You also have Elijah Lee. Can Elijah Lee step up? I'm assuming they'll bring him up off the practice squad. So it'll be Leo Chanel and Elijah Lee to step up. In these games, you have to face it, Jonathan Taylor, this upcoming game versus the Colts. Then in a couple weeks, you have to go face Josh Allen, the Buffalo Bills. That's going to be a hard task. That is when you would want Willie Gay to play. Then you have Tom Brady. Those are 3 games right there that are coming up that are huge games for the Kansas City Chiefs, especially for their linebacking crew. So can Elijah Lee or Leo Chanel step up for the absence of Willie Gay? Now we're going to move on to the AFC West, and this is something I want to talk about after Sunday's games in the AFC West. We saw the Denver Broncos. They played the Houston Texans, starting off with the Denver Broncos. And some of the coaching that is going on in Denver is just absolutely terrible, and it's not looking good for the Denver Broncos this early in the season for Nathaniel Hackett and the Denver Broncos. Fans were counting down the play clock because they had so many false starts because they could not get the plays in for the Denver Broncos. It's already looking bad in Denver for Nathaniel Hackett. Are players going to start questioning if he's the right guy for the job? Russell Wilson is not looking like Russell Wilson. They could only put up 16 points. Yes, they won the game. That's what matters. But they only put up 16 points against a Houston Texans squad. If that would have been any other team, they would have lost that game. Not a good start for the Denver Broncos. Los Angeles Chargers, we saw them versus the Kansas City Chiefs on Thursday. We know how they're looking with all the injuries that are starting to pop up for that Chargers team. Justin Herbert, how is he going to be after this cartilage to his rib that is injured? So we don't know about the Chargers. There's a lot of question marks there. Can Chase Daniels maybe carry them for a game or two? And Lastly, the Oakland Raiders. The absolute collapse of the Oakland Raiders on Sunday versus the Arizona Cardinals, who a Kansas City Chiefs team handled very, very easily in Arizona. Home opener. They go there in Oakland. They're up by 3 possessions. Kyler Murray marches down and ends up winning the game. End of the game, you had some questionable coaching calls by Josh McDaniels as they decided to pass the ball. Hunter Renfrow fumbles the ball. Arizona gets it, scoops it up, and wins the game. Arizona, a team that struggled versus the Kansas City Chiefs, was able to climb back versus the Oakland Raiders and, Las Vegas Raiders, still saying Oakland, and climb back and win a game. Derek Carr trying to target Devontae Adams maybe too much. I know that's his buddy. I know that's his friend. But it's almost like a situation where the Chiefs had with Tyreek last year is maybe they get target happy with one player. But outside of Hunter Renfrow, Darren Waller, and Devontae Adams, that team is relatively not a great team. You have Max Crosby over there. Chandler Jones has not looked great so far. But that defense of the Las Vegas Raiders is not looking good so far. Well, guys, that'll do it for today's video. Guys, I brought you some breaking news with Willie Gay suspension. We'll have more about Willie Gay and what the Chiefs need to do on Friday for the preview of the Indianapolis Colts versus Kansas City Chiefs. Make sure you guys are liked, subscribed, and you guys hit that notification bell.
Thanks for watching. Make sure you hit subscribe and the notification bell to see our videos each week. This episode's also brought to you by Jaden's Jerseys. Gear up, America.